Welcome back to the show. Well, by the title card, you can tell that we're working on another steampunk style project from MoYu store. Now, they watched my review on the dragonfly that I had built, and I was a little critical of that one. I had said that it was a little overpriced for what you got, and some of the design made it hard to go together, and I had stabbed my hand. Well, if you remember that review, the stab is just about healed up on my palm there. They said we've got a new design. It's way less than half the price of the dragonfly. It's got fewer parts. It's still built with wood and brass and small screws, and it's electric powered. It is a mechanical butterfly, and it's got a beautiful wood base, brass parts, got everything on there. So I said, sure, I'll take a look at this one and see what we got. Now, this one comes in extremely similar to the other one. Most of their designs are very similar. They're going to give you the screwdriver, which in my honest opinion is kind of useless. We'll see if the design is a little improved. It looks a little different. They've got the nice Allen wrench included for you. Nice pair of tweezers. Nice four-way wrench, which will obviously be recognized by the radio control guys as two. This has been shipped in a billion Traxxas and Kyosho and other types of vehicle. And the nice sanding pad, which comes in handy for the plastic model guys. So you get that in a nice compartment. We've got laser-cut wood parts. Being a smaller model with fewer parts, we're not going to see nearly as much wood parts. But these are beautifully done and laser-etched to look like the veins in a butterfly's wing. Pre-drilled, all cut out. Since they're laser cut, all the edges have been refined, and then they stain the wood. You can see the different styles of the butterfly wing. Looks just like half a butterfly right there. Very beautiful. And the natural wood will have variations in the grain and the way it looks. It is very nice. Feels lightweight. They've also got some plastic parts. Do you remember building with your grandma or your mom on rainy days? Those plastic things that you would fill the metal frame with plastic dots and then melt it in your oven to make a beautiful design. That's exactly what this reminds me of. It's got the silver borders. It looks like leaded glass, but it is plastic. Matte on one side with the shiny glitter and much shinier on the front side that you'll be able to see the most of. Lovely looking plastic parts to coincide with those wooden parts. And it reminds me of those from the 80s, those melting plastics. Now in this little compartment, and you get all these compartments of course to keep when you're done, are the brass mechanical pieces. And this is where I ran into some trouble last time with the holes not being large enough. I can already tell now they look like they are larger to fit the size of the hardware that was included. We got cool gears. We've got armatures. Look at that. Scroll work like that. Beautiful, definitely fits the steampunk design. We got mounts for different types of gears in there. We got two longer control arms. So it does look like the holes might be larger, more accepting, especially on the smaller parts. Looks like it's going to fit that hardware a little better. We're going to find out when I start to assemble it, because I always give you an honest opinion. In this box here, we've got a lot of the doodads. Now, when you receive yours, sometimes the way these are handled in shipping, they're all over the place inside the box. So use the illustration on the top, organize your parts, and you're not gonna have any problems. Check out, it's really in there. Check out that heavy duty brass gearing. I mean, that is a solid piece of metal. Look at the bearing in there, pressed in. That is some heavy, heavy duty stuff. We got some sort of a ball mount or something here. It looks like it's going to screw in and hold a rod in that side. So we've got some cool stuff. I don't even know what these are. It's like got a spring with a piece of brass wire with a little bit of an angle to it. They're both bent like that. This one you'll recognize again, the RC guy's pinion gear from an electric RC motor. So that's pretty cool. This box here, we're not done. There's a lot of stuff in this kit. We got all our little screws and hardware. We got all the set screws with the Allen wrench. We've got our assembly screws, the brass screws, the nuts. We got the larger bolts and nuts. We got some duplexers. We got some cap nuts there. We got some extensions here, some spreaders. So we got all cool hardware. I made sure and confirmed that everything was in its box the way it should be. Then we get on to the last pieces, which I was really surprised by. One, the gorgeous base with the brass gearing on top. Check that out. It's got a nice soft wood base, nice plastic mount with brass inserts so you don't strip out the plastic. Beautifully stained piece of wood, turned on a lathe for sure, and decorated beautifully. And then a wireless charge port. You can actually use this with your phone. Outputs 5 volts at 2 amps, 9 volts at 2 amps. That is a fast charger with USB cable. And that is what will power the base. We don't have to plug it into anything. We're supposed to just be able to set it on the top and make it run. Will that work? I don't know. But we're about to find out because I am going to start building mine. It's all finished, and it's a night and day difference. I didn't, as you saw, I was like cheering because I could just press the bolts through and get the nuts on. I didn't have to fight anything. There are some things that you could use a couple hands for, and it takes a little bit longer, like getting this assembly here put together and whatnot. We'll use the screwdriver for what it's actually good for, which is pointing stuff out. It's still not very good for working on the model. I use my own screwdrivers on the side, and you've got a couple of the larger nuts that the wrench won't fit on, so I just used my other nut drivers. You can hold them with a pair of pliers. Anything is very simple. The kit goes together very easily. The manual is extremely well done. Tells you exactly how to line things up. You know, it says make the length of the two sides the same. Makes everything really easy, and everything is labeled appropriately in that manual and makes it easy and fun to put together. You're still going to have your sanding stick. Nice set of tweezers. These will come in handy. You got the little Allen wrench. You got the four-way wrench. You've got the charging base. We're going to show that in a little bit. And we've got the USB cable. Now, I was a little mistaken at thinking that we could use the stained glass and the wood together. I thought they were going to end up like overlapping each other. But what is it? It's two-in-one kit, like a Revell or an AMT kit that I built. You can either use the wooden wings, which are absolutely gorgeous, to go for the full antique steampunk look, with those reddish wood on the wings to match. See, it's how it contrasts the base. Or you can go with the stained glass. Now, I wanted to go with the stained glass. I really like the look of that, and it reminds me of those toys I would build with my mom and my grandma on snow days and stuff like that, where you'd melt the plastic, so I wanted to use that. It's really cool with these little spring mechanisms underneath. It's a nice, durable piece of machinery. I mean, it's not gonna fall apart. You can twist it around. and all that, and I've got it on the turntable so you can see it. You get to see the gears work. When you place it on the bass, it takes 4 or 5 seconds, and it'll start to work once it senses the motor on there. And what I'm going to do is close out the video and just put some music on, put this in my photography box, and just let it run. So you can actually see it run through the full movement. It doesn't bind up. It doesn't do anything. It just works beautifully. So what I'm thinking is MoYu Store has this gorgeous all-metal V8 motor. And I've been asking them to send that because that's more on the line of what you guys want to see. So they said, we'll try the Butterfly next. I said, okay, since we had some difficulties with the Dragonfly, I tried the Butterfly, and it is beautiful. They fixed all the bugs. They engineered it correctly. It worked right out of the box. Nothing had to be re-drilled or re-tapped or squeezed or bent or tweaked. It all just worked exactly as it is. So I will link down to that. And then we're going to hope that they send that big assembly V8, because I know you guys want to see it. It's a monster of a metal engine, and I can't wait to put it together. So we'll close out with the Butterfly running to some music, and I will see all of you at the next.